In this video, we're going to take a look at a few of the different ways that we can modify dimensions in an Autodesk Inventor drawing. First of all, I can move dimensions around by selecting them and clicking and dragging them. Here you can see I can drag just the text to bring it off with a leader. I can also click and drag on the dimension line itself to change it. I can also adjust precision. If I select a dimension, I can right-click, point to precision, and choose a different number of decimal places. So maybe I'll remove the decimal places from this one. I can also change the way in which it's placed. As you can see, the arrowheads were placed on the inside and the text was moved to the outside. I can click and drag the text and bring it to the other side, but I can't really drag it into the middle here. What I can do though is I can right click, point to options, and turn off arrowheads inside. Now you can see that I can actually bring the dimension to the inside there. We can also make some changes to the dimension text itself. So here I have a dimension for a diameter, and I want to add the note of 4x to this one. I'm going to double click on the text to open up the text editor here. As you can see, I have my associate of dimension here. My blinking cursor is after it, so I'm going to arrow over to the front of it and just simply add in my note of 4x here. As you can see, I have several different symbols I can put in, some geometric dimensioning and tolerancing, other symbols as well. For example, if I wanted to put in a depth value, I could do something like that as well. You can even replace the dimension text. Obviously, we don't want to replace dimensions with incorrect values, but if maybe I was going to put in a placeholder text there, I can't delete the associative dimension, but I can hide it with this checkbox here. And then I can type in something else. So maybe it's a not to scale value, or maybe it's just a text label, like so. One final way we'll look at for changing dimensions is changing the dimension style. If I select a dimension, I can see the style in which it was created up top here. If I click the dropdown, this particular template has 5 different types of dimensions. I can switch to ANSI. And you can see this one's going to give me inches now. I can choose default fraction, and I can set it back to millimeters, or I can have it give me 2 different units. So I can have it simultaneously give me inches and millimeters. Again, this is all dependent on the template, so you may have different styles available in your drop-down list. That concludes this look at modifying dimensions in an Autodesk Inventor drawing.